And then he gives us an ought against our brother and our sister. It's your fault. Peter was trying to fight a spiritual thing in carnality. And a lot of times that what we will fight the spiritual war in carnality. Let me tell you, I was married for just short of 40 years. When I was wedded from 15 till I was 55. But let me tell you something, women of God, the man is the head.
Because the devil is not playing.
to kill you. Saul lost the kingdom because of people.
Jesus, help me.
He was a people pleaser. And he didn't obey God when God told him to go down to the Amalekites. Kill them all. But he brought back the king. He brought back the best mules and everything. When God tells us something, we got to do just like he said. Even Samuel went back to say, God, he said, I have rejected him. I'm done with him. We don't want to be rejected, do we? We talked about obedience in Sunday school. Because if we are not obedient, we won't make it. We won't make it. We're hollering, give me a prophecy. Here it is. Love your enemy. Love your neighbor as yourself. And who is your enemy? He doesn't tell us to love the devil, so there's some people that are against us. But you don't target the people because it's the spirit within them that target. Let me tell you something. The devil don't like you. If you are anyway walking in the word, the devil don't like you. If you change at all, he don't like you.
That's right.
But let me tell you something. As many of us that's in here today call by the name of God, when we put our foot on the floor this morning, the devil should have been scared. Right. Come on now. One should face 1,000, 2, 10,000. How many of us is in here call by the name of the Lord? There should not he said, speak to the mountain. And be moved. But see, he told me, quit talking about it and speak to it. That's what we do. We talk about it too much instead of speaking to it. But I told him at church one day, I said, listen, I tell you what, my boys may choose not to live right.
Come on.
And they may choose to go to hell, because that's a choice.
That's right.
I pray that they don't. Right. But they're going to have a hard time getting there.
Yes.
Because when I think about the prayer that I pray, yes, and the prayer of the righteous, the faithless mothers, when I think about it, thank you. Jesus.
Freaky Freddy in your bed.
it comes to cut a thunder. All the way down to the marrow. But this word I know will cause you to bleed and hurt. Hallelujah. This word will cause you to cry. This word, hallelujah, will convict your heart. But the same word will heal you.
Remember that the war has been won. We got battles, but
But the Lord is giants. Spirit of depression that I see in the house of God is a giant. Fear of failure, disappointment, not being able to trust. It's hard to love when you don't trust. Habits, putting up walls, afraid to love again is a giant. Hurts, painful memories, rejection, pushed aside, and Lord, unforgiveness. But we have a weapon, the Word of God. Our weapon is praise. Whatever the devil tells you not to do, make sure you do. If you say don't speak to her, make sure you go straight to her. If you say don't speak to him, go straight to him. Don't listen if you know it's not right. But see, we need the oil of God in order to be filled with the oil of God so we can make the right choices. We got to be filled with the oil of God, the Holy Ghost, that will lead and guide us into all truth. That when people hurt you, you don't have that spirit to want to hurt them back. I've never really been a fighter. But you know, after being pushed aside and doing all those things in the world will make you be something you probably wasn't.
That's right.
I'm still not a fighter. I remember my grandmother would whip me because I wouldn't fight a sister, and I would leave her nameless because she always picked on me. But I tell you what, you can love people so much until you don't want to harm them, because love will cause you to not want to harm them.
Amen.
That it don't come up in your head to harm.
Amen.
She would pinch me, scratch me, just scratch for nothing. But I loved her so much until I didn't want her. Until one day, and I'll tell that another story. But I will tell you this. Isaiah 54:17 says, no one born of the shall prosper. And every tongue that shall rise against you in judgment, thou shalt condemn. So don't let words stop you. You are greater than what you know. God has something greater for you. David could not become king. He had to kill the giant. Saul was too afraid. He had the first opportunity to kill the giant. Don't be afraid to face your giant. Defeat him. Every challenge you get, then you got to kill it. Kill it. First of all, sometimes we're too full of us. But you know, the altar is a killing place.
Right.
But you know, I like to hear this. These are things coming to me. Don't ask me no more. Without the word. But I tell you, she had to die. She had to die. Her wants, her desires had to die. Because she was no good for me. She had to die. Her way of doing things had to die. It had to be replaced with what God wanted. Because he saw me now. To be able to get to where God wants you to be, we can no longer be us.
That's right.
earth as it is in heaven. He wants us to live by the kingdom of God. And that's what this flesh, this carnality, will not let us live by the kingdom roof unless we get it under subjection. Because if you kill my dog, I'm gonna kill your dog. That's what the world does. But love is the greatest. If you love me, if I love you, I will not hurt you intentionally. Now the word comes, ain't my word. It might hurt you. But even if you preach the word, it hurts someone, it's not an intent, and I'm happy about it. If it is, that thing in you needs to die, or in me. It's not about us. And until we get into our cute little self, when we look in the mirror and we're cute, dressed to kill, then turned around, pivoted, cute. Cute shoes, I got so many shoes, can't wear. Don't get old. Cute. I tell folks, come to church cute. Don't matter how you go when you
right.
If God done roll you, he done roll you. Doesn't matter what you look like when you leave. But if that cuteness is keeping you getting in the service, don't be cute. Don't be a nun you can't sweat in. You can't hug in. You can't get down on your knees in. Don't be too cute. You can't praise God. We're standing all over the building. I thank God for the pastor that has allowed me this time.